Welcome to all of you on my channel. Let me introduce myself. I'm Aziz, an accomplished professional and executive management advisor with an extensive experience of over 20 years, specialized in strategic and business planning, performance management, change management. Having an ability to link strategic big-picture thinking with operational results, leading to the development of strategic and business planning frameworks for the organization in closing business gaps, identifying potential opportunities, developing innovative and cost-effective recommendations for meeting user units' needs and management expectations. Playing an anchoring role between business and strategic functions. Planning, risk management, monitoring, and aligning overall corporate and departmental performance using balanced scorecards and performance management system KPIs, driving business excellence through process improvements and quality initiatives. Effectively communicating strategic direction set by executive management and establish a framework of performance management at executive level and across organizations' business and support divisions. I'd like to present to you today is about planning, and this course will be in different parts. Let's begin.
Abstract. This article will provide the overview of planning, management, how to succeed, importance, reason of failure and success, principles, nature, main elements, approaches, types of planning, advantages and disadvantages, process and decision making. In this article, you will find Introduction. Definition of planning. Why planning needed. How to succeed, importance, reason of failure and success. Principles, nature, main elements, approaches and types of planning. Advantages and disadvantages. Planning process and decision making.
What planning is planning? Has traditionally been linked to increased efficiency and long-term growth. However, in today's fast-paced world and fierce market rivalry, management planning is crucial. As a result, whether you like it or not, the familiar management saying holds true: if you fail to plan, plan to fail. Management's main and fundamental job is planning. Without effective planning, no organization can function successfully. Planning is a stage before taking action. It refers to systematic pre-planning in order to determine a path of action to attain a certain goal. Planning is simply the act of choosing ahead of time in advance. What will be done? How to do? When to do it? Who will do it? The management establishes the overall objectives of the organization, as well as the manager set the goals of its individual sections, via planning. Then he goes on to create a sort of blueprint outlining how to achieve these goals. Therefore, planning may be defined as follows. Planning is the process through which an organization's management establish objectives, analyze the future, and outline a course of action to achieve the organization's goals. From this definition, it's clear that the planning process involves the determination of appropriate goals and objectives, the specification of the actions needed to reach the established objectives, and the optimum period of time for achieving them. Planning is connected with the identification of possibilities and the selection of the most advantageous solution. It is appropriately referred to as the most fundamental instrument of management activities. Thus, planning is the act of determining corporate objectives and mapping out in a sensible way to achieve those objectives. Definitions of planning. Mainly, planning can be defined as thinking in advance what is to be done, when it is to be done, how it is to be done, and by whom it should be done. Here is definition by few authors as follows. Definition by Kuntz and O'Donnell. Planning is an intellectual process, the conscious determination of courses of action, the basing of decisions on purpose, facts, and considered estimates. Definition by George Terry. By means of planning, management members try to look ahead, anticipate eventualities, prepare for contingencies, map out activities and provide an orderly sequence for achieving the objective. Now I will explain why we need planning. To get the answer of why we need planning, the answer is, planning and evaluation are vital for organizations. Planning is a process of deciding in advance where we want to get to, our goal, and how we will get there. It helps us precisely in defining our objectives. It forces us to make a clear and specific decision about what we must do to have the desired impact. It makes us in deciding clearly and concretely what we need to do to have the impact on organization. We all will understand our goal and what we need to do to reach it by involving everyone in the planning process. It makes us all work in a goal-oriented way rather than in a loose or ad hoc way where we just respond to issues and crises with no clear plan or goal. Planning in advance can help us achieve our goal and those things that can prevent us from achieving our goal and work out what to do about them, and we are accountable for what we do. It also helps us to know and use of our resources, people, time, money, information, equipment, so that they make the most significant contribution to achieving our goal. Evaluation enables us to assess how well we are doing from this. Evaluation helps the whole organization to identify how we could improve what we are achieving, take action to build on successes and avoid repeating failures. Effective evaluation enables us to use what we have learned from our experience to improve what we are achieving. For more clarity, we will understand different aspects of the planning, likewise, characteristics and importance, process, training, etc. In this article, I'm just concerned to give you the clarity in understanding of word planning, corporate/operational. Now, on a later stage, we will discuss about the procurement planning in supply chain and how it can be effective in resource planning, manpower deployment, for procuring of products, services and control supply delivery. How to succeed and fail in planning. Now in this section we will see how to succeed and fail in planning. First we will discuss the succession planning. Factors to successful strategic planning. If you realize the value of planning in management and wish to reap all of its benefits, explore the five aspects that influence planning effectiveness. Engagement. Although planning is a managerial role, it should not be performed by a single individual behind closed doors. On the contrary, it is a manager's responsibility to make planning a collaborative and inclusive process. Make your staff feel included in the planning process, and they will be willing to commit to the plan and share responsibility for its implementation. Data, not assumptions. We all have assumptions about businesses and markets, but they are not always correct. Making assumptions in your strategy is a serious error that negates all of the benefits of careful planning. It is critical to conduct market research, hold focus groups, speak with one's own staff, and contact market specialists in order to base judgments on evidence rather than preconceptions. Communication. It is critical to properly explain to staff the targeted outcomes and the strategic plan. Encourage open communication by inviting everyone to provide input and suggestions for improving the strategy. It is important to note that some planning advantages, such as creativity, are dependent on how ready people are to share their ideas and if they feel acknowledged and valued for doing so. Culture of growth. Only in a culture that prioritizes efficiency and growth can a sincere emphasis on enhancing efficiency and growth be maintained. Work to develop such a culture in your company. Employees will be more inclined to commit to ambitious objectives and demanding plans if you assist them learn and grow their abilities and acknowledge and reward personal successes. Commitment to change. Effective planning necessitates the elimination of obsolete procedures, the modification of plans, innovation, recruiting, and firing. All of this implies change, which can be tough to manage. To genuinely reap the benefits of planning, though, a manager must be willing to move beyond cosmetic modifications and risk the team's displeasure. In this regard, management planning is a role that demands a great deal of bravery and dedication. Now we will discuss the main reasons of failure of plan. Although planning is a fundamental management role, many managers ignore it in practice. We should assume they don't need formal sorts of planning since they can keep the organization on track with their strategic vision and gut feeling. This, however, is not the case. The following are the primary reasons why managers fail to develop a strategic plan. Underestimate the importance of planning. Many managers have a get-things-done mentality, forgetting to pause and consider what they really need to do. They have no idea how planning affects performance and are unwilling to modify anything. Lack time for planning. Planning takes a long time, and managers are overburdened with duties. As a result, it is usual for managers to ponder about strategic goals only while they are at home or on their way to work. This might lead to a lack of planning. Managers should dedicate time to planning. If finding time for this function is challenging, a manager should outsource additional responsibility and minimize micromanaging. Don't have the necessary knowledge. Many tools are used in planning, including SWOT analysis, steeple analysis, the VRIO framework, environmental scanning, resource analysis, and so on. If a manager does not have enough management training, he or she may fail to plan properly and hence find no need in doing so. It's also possible that they lack knowledge in specific areas, such as marketing planning, which is significantly different from operational planning. Managers have too much reliance on their experience. Some managers may have achieved success in the absence of planning, leading them to believe that planning is a waste of time. They ascribe their achievement to their ability rather than favorable circumstances. Lack of self-discipline. Setting and achieving objectives, whether personal or organizational, needs commitment and discipline. Managers frequently need to enhance their own talents and abilities in order to plan well. Lack of meaningful objectives and goals. Managers may ignore planning when there is no purpose to engage or drive them to do so. This is common in businesses that do not have a mission statement. Please follow the next video part 2 for more on the topic. I hope you enjoyed this video, and before leaving, if you have not already subscribed this channel, make sure to subscribe, like and hit the bell icon to get updates when I post new videos. Provide your feedback in comments. You can download material from the below links under video.